Now, as the federal government restarts its engines and the debt ceiling battle fades away, we return to the matter that triggered Republican anger at the outset, the rollout of the health insurance exchanges mandated by the Affordable Care Act. The online launch of the federal version, a marketplace at healthcare.gov that operates in more than 35 states, has been beset by glitches. Ray Suarez has our update on the problems plaguing the site.
Under mounting criticism, the Obama administration is acknowledging the difficulties a bit more explicitly this week. During an appearance in Cincinnati on Wednesday, Health and Human Services Secretary Kathleen Sebelius said, "I will be the first to tell you that the website launch was rockier than we wanted it to be. 2 weeks later, there are vast improvements, but we are still not satisfied." We check in with two chronicling this story extensively, Sarah Kliff of The Washington Post and Louise Radnofsky of The Wall Street Journal. Well, Sarah, let me start with you. The much-publicized problems of the rollout. If you go today, what is waiting for you there?
That's a good question, and it actually varies by person right now. I myself was able to log into the federal website for the first time on Wednesday, and I hear from some readers who actually enrolled insurance. Some of them have gotten help from the federal government paying for their premiums. Others are stuck at error messages. Others can't even get through the application process. And I think that's why you see the administration at this point acknowledging the fact it's been a rocky rollout is that we're 18 days into the open enrollment process, and it still really runs the gamut what experience people are having.
You did it in the state of Virginia?
Yes, yes.
Was this something that took multiple tries?
It did. I actually cannot tell you how many tries it took because it was so many. And I was able to get in on Wednesday, so that's still over 2 weeks into the launch. Once I was able to use the website, it was actually a relatively smooth experience, a few wait screens here and there. But I still hear from a lot of readers and people I've been interviewing who can't get that far, which suggests that the problems are still far from fixed.
Louise, has there been a tapering off of traffic? And has that allowed the government to catch its breath, play a little catch-up with its technical gremlins?
Well, it sounds like there's been a tapering off of traffic, just people who are turning up at the site at all. But also, the federal government put a fix onto the website last Thursday with little fanfare that allowed people to browse anonymously for the first time. And so that reduced the number of people who were then having to set up accounts in order to window shop and reduce the flow of people who already had coverage and were just curious about what premiums looked like, which meant that in turn, it seems like the number of people who are successfully creating accounts, who are trying to, has gone up to about one in four now. What we're also seeing, though, is that there are some problems that are following from that.
Now, when you say successfully creating accounts, that's a precondition for actually even shopping and buying, right? You first have to identify yourself and set yourself up as a user on the site, right?
It's no longer a precondition for browsing, but for shopping, seriously, it is. You have to tell the site who you are and have it essentially verify that you're telling the truth. And we've had, like Sarah, I've heard from readers who are struggling at the identity verification stage with some corresponding identity issues of their own. I am who I say I am. I've been the same person for 45 years. Why don't you believe me?
Now, Sarah, it's a 6-month window for signing up. So, in fact, there's a long time before this is over. But if you want to be covered on January 1st, the first day this new insurance takes effect, by when should these problems be cleared up in order to have a trouble-free experience? Be all signed up and certified so that when January 1st comes, you're covered.
So the very last day you can sign up and be covered by January 1st is December 15th. That gives the insurance companies about 2 weeks to process the paperwork. When I talk to advocates, right now they're not worried. They point out what you pointed out, that this is a long enrollment period. They'll often say it's a marathon, it's not a sprint. But they say if by the end of this month, especially if by Thanksgiving, these problems aren't fixed, that's a really big problem because you really need to give people some time to weigh these decisions. We're talking about a big financial decision of purchasing an insurance policy. So really, if these aren't fixed by early November, mid-November, then I think that's a really significant problem for the administration.
Well, Louise, with that in mind, have a lot of resources been thrown at getting this fixed?
We think so. The administration has said it has a plan. It hasn't been very forthcoming about what the details of that plan are, and that it is working around the clock to get it fixed, but its timeline for getting it fixed as soon as possible, which is not necessarily the sort of timeline that the advocates would like. They'd like some reassurances that it'll be done now. We're also hearing from members of Congress, Democrats across the board, who are saying that they want it done on a timeline that is now.
Now, a wait screen is one thing. It's maddening, but it's a wait screen. There are reports now, and help me out with this, that people who are submitting their information online are finding out that the data that's been recorded is incorrect, that the site is actually not taking up the data they enter properly.
Right. Well, we've reported this morning that insurers are finding that the trickle of people who are making it to the final stage and actually enrolling in an insurance plan are turning up, for example, in triplicate. Or we had an insurer who found one person who turned up with three spouses. They were actually dependents. And right now, while very few people are coming through all the hurdles because they're getting stopped in some cases at earlier stages, or they're genuinely weighing the decision and it's slowing them down, they can handle this, the insurers. They're able to manually go through the forms and check for errors. But that's because they're getting 50, 60 enrollees. The fear is that when the initial barriers come down, more people start coming through. The volume at that point, if there are still glitches in the way that the information is conveyed to insurers, could become a real problem. And that could also impact some of the back-end deadlines, like December 15th.
Is it a different story, a better story, perhaps, in those states that are running their own exchanges rather than having the federal government do it?
It runs the gamut a little bit. There are a few states that have been standouts. Kentucky, for example, is one that has enrolled thousands, tens of thousands of people already. Washington State has seen a lot of success with their marketplaces. Then you look at a state like Hawaii that really wanted this to work. They only got their website up just this past Tuesday, 2 weeks after it was supposed to be up. Oregon announced today they haven't been able to enroll anyone into private health insurance plans. And Hawaii and Oregon are states that really wanted this to work. They decided to take on the efforts of setting up these marketplaces. So you do really see a big span among the state-based exchanges of how well this is going for them right now.
Is there a targeted number, a whisper number, you might say, that the federal government wanted to hit, that the Obama administration wanted to hit by this first month of the rollout? And is there a shot at actually reaching that level?
Well, the Congressional Budget Office projected that 7 million people would come in over the open enrollment season overall. There's an internal memo that I think has been floating around, reported by the Associated Press, that had a first month target that I think was 50,000. So they were always planning, and they told us this too, they were always planning for October to be slower than November, to be slower than December, that people would be motivated by deadlines. And they expected even that some people might miss the initial deadline but sign up early in the new year and not be subject to the mandate. It's not clear, of course, whether they're hitting that target because we haven't seen those numbers.
Will they be slowed up, those numbers, by the government shutdown?
There's not a reason why they should be slowed up by the government shutdown. The administration said they want to release them in November because they want to make sure that they're accurate. One of the reasons is they want to match all the different data entry sources, the paper forms, the call center forms, and the website. The other thing is they want to make sure there aren't duplicates. And what we're hearing from insurers are there are duplicates.
Now that the titanic political struggle is over, is it likely that this is going to get its troubles and its successes likely to get a lot more attention in the coming weeks?
I think so. It was actually, in a way, it was a good time for the administration to launch a website that didn't work very well on October 1st. There was all this focus on the federal government shutting down. And really, that's been the big story that all of our colleagues have been covering. Healthcare.gov has certainly been, you know, a top news item, but it's definitely been pushed out of first place by the shutdown. Now that the government is reopened, I think a lot of the focus is going to move back to this website, which makes it, you know, even more imperative and, you know, even a higher agenda item for the White House to get it fixed and get it running accurately now that people are really starting to come to it, even in higher numbers.
Sarah Kliff of The Washington Post, Louise Radnofsky of The Wall Street Journal. Thank you both.
Thank you.